2. Operation of chassis. 2.1. Precautions before operating. Before working, you must check solidity, load-bearing, and pressure-resistant capacity of the work ground. Before operating the crane, the following items shall be checked. 1. Fix the main hook and retract every boom and the front jack to the proper position. 2. Check steering drive shaft, booster pump, booster cylinder, and whether conducting part is firm or not. 3. Check the front left first axle, including two tires for air pressure and appearance, wing nuts, tire air chamber, horse riding bolts, and so on. Check the wear situation of the main drive shaft once a week to ensure driving safety. 4. Open the outrigger control box at the left side to ensure the emergency stop switch had been reset. Otherwise, you cannot start the engine. Same for the control box at right side. 5. Now check the left front outrigger. More details shall be concerned at this part. First, check hydraulic lock, the outrigger telescope rope, telescope wheels, and relevant oil pipes for damage, loose and oil leaking risks. Check the electromagnetic valve to ensure that the wire plug is inserted firmly and that no oil leaks from the oil pipe. At last, outrigger plates shall be fixed firmly and the vertical cylinder shall be retracted to its proper position. Of course, we shall check the other three outriggers in the same way. 6. Check that the oil-water separator and fuel pipes are free of cracks or oil leakage. Meanwhile, check that those several air tanks cannot be loose and the air pipes are free of cracks. At this moment, please look up to check whether the turntable fixed pin is locked. This pin should be locked when traveling. 7. Check the rear left third and fourth axle, including four tires for air pressure, appearance, wheel nuts, the tire air chamber, and horse riding bolts, and so on. The opposite third and fourth axles shall also be checked in the same way. 8. Standing between the third and the fourth axles, check the pipes and lines under the control room and on the main valve for damaged oil pipes and broken lines. 9. At the rear of the crane, make sure that the spare tires and reversing cameras work normally, and then lift your head up to make sure no oil leakage from the oil cooler. 10. Check the right rear rigger, third and fourth axles in the same method as the left side. 11. Check the air conditioning pipes on the turntable and the ones on the slewing mechanism for oil leakage or damaged oil pipe. Special attention shall be paid to ensure that fixed bolts on the rotary reducer are not missed or loose, and that output shaft shall be free of crack. 12. Make sure that the oil level of the hydraulic tank is above the specified level line. And check the front right rigger and the front right first and second axles in the same method as step 3 and step 5. 13. Climb up to the platform with ladder using 3-point fixation method to check batteries, coolant, power steering tank, brake oil, and open the engine hood to check the engine. Check whether all engine parts are loose by shaking them. After completion of the above works, you can enter into the operator's cab to start the next operation. 2.2. Getting into, out of driver's cab. Prior to entering into the operator's cab, 1. You must use handrail and pedal to support your body tightly by means of 3-point support, and you shall not jump up or off the crane. 2. Do not climb up or down the crane with something in hand. You can climb up or down only after it has been fully, steadily stopped. 2.3. Operation of driver's cab. When you enter into the driver's cab, sitting at the driver's seat, first adjust the seat to the comfortable position and reset all rocker switches to the non-working positions respectively. Do remember to check and ensure that the power takeoff rocker switch is at off state and set the gear lever to the neutral position. 1. Insert the key into the key switch and turn it until the electric circuit is connected. Check whether all instrument values are normal. If an alarm is issued, be sure to find out the cause and take measures. 2. Push down the clutch pedal slightly and meanwhile rotate the start key to start the engine. Time of each start shall not be more than 5 to 8 seconds. If the first start fails, wait for 1 minute and start it again. And if it fails for 3 to 5 times, you shall stop to check the reason. 3. Push down throttle slightly after starting the engine to keep it running at an idle speed for a certain period of time. Before traveling, make sure that all instruments of the crane must be normal. 1. The start of machine will be later than the engine starting, parking brake releasing, and pushing down of the clutch pedal. 2. Set the transmission handle to gear 1. Release the clutch pedal slowly, slightly step on the throttle, and then the machine can be started. 3. To shift the gear of transmission, you shall push the clutch pedal to disconnect the clutch completely. Set the operating handle to the position required and then release the clutch pedal. 4. This machine's single H gear shift is a kind of gear shift used on a combined transmission. If the transmission shifts within low gear zone, gear 1 to 4, or high gear zone, gear 5 to 8, it is controlled directly by gear lever. 5. If it shifts from low gear zone to high gear zone or vice versa, you shall simultaneously operate the gear lever and the high and low gear shift switch on gear lever handle. The brake system of this vehicle contains 1. Traveling brake and parking brake. Traveling brake is controlled by pedal and its dual circuit pneumatic brake with 0.79 megapascals rated working pressure. The handbrake is located at the right side of the driver's seat, by which emergency and parking brake can be done. You can pull the handbrake handle to lock position to park the crane. 2. The exhaust brake switch is located on the left handle of the combined switch. If the end face of the left handle is downwards, the exhaust brake will be in work state and meanwhile the exhaust brake indicator lamp will be on. If the left handle is set to the position, the exhaust brake will be closed and the lamp will be off. 2 requirements must be met to use the exhaust brake. 1. Not to push the clutch and the throttle. The gear shall not be in neutral. 2. The rotation speed of engine must be between 1,300 to 2,200 RPM. Power takeoff operation steps. 1. You shall first let the parking brake be in a brake state and ensure that the gear lever and power takeoff are definitely in neutral and disconnected state. 2. Push the clutch pedal to its limit position while starting the engine. Pull the transmission to a required gear position 4. Connect the power takeoff and slowly release the clutch pedal. Now the power takeoff's indicator shall be on. 2.4 Outrigger Operation Panel. Attention! The left outrigger controller controls the front left, rear left horizontal outriggers. And the one on the right side controls the front right, rear right horizontal outriggers. Operation to extend horizontal and vertical outriggers shall be as follows. 1. Connect the power takeoff to make sure that the oil pump is working. 2. Turn on the outrigger master power switch in the driver's cab. 3. Pull out the horizontal outrigger lock pin and install the outrigger tray. 4. Open the outrigger control box door and press the start switch. 5. Turn on the outrigger working lamp switch. 6. Constantly press the horizontal outrigger extension button. 7. When the 4 horizontal outriggers all extend out in place, constantly press all vertical outrigger extension switch and level the frame. With respect to the crane leveling operation, observe the level meter. If the central level indicator lamp comes on, it indicates that the crane is leveled or otherwise you need to make it level. 8. Follow the work condition and select to extend out the front jack. Constantly press the front jack extension button until the front jack plate is about 5 millimeters away from the ground and then release the button. 9. To extend and retract the counterweight cylinder, press the counterweight cylinder control button in the outrigger control box. 10. With all works finished, turn off the working lamp switch and close the outrigger control box door.